Hi friends, how are you? I hope you're having a very nice time and your weekend was really good. So, you know, I was given this channeling around last night towards going to sleep, because I go to sleep very late in the night and I have to again wake up quite early. But it was given to me, like, I think maybe when I was taking a very late evening 10 minutes nap or something, you know. So this channeling is actually a continuation of the previous channeling which came out, because they were showing me the links, you know. So now I will just start with the channeling right away so that you can know what I'm talking about, you know. So let's begin, folks. So as I was lying down on my bed, what was shown to me is that the divine masculine collective, they were actually having a very sad facial expression, you know. One of the divine masculine collective, like the divine masculine collective energy, came through one masculine, and he was showing me his face, and he was looking very disturbed, you know. He was looking very not getting a way through, you know. That was his energy, that he cannot get a way through, you know, through something. He wants to go from point A to point B, and he cannot get a passage, you know. He cannot get the right of passage through. That was what he was trying to convey to me. He was not speaking any words, but he was trying to convey to me through his facial expressions. Can you believe that? I'm sure you can by now, you know, if you're following me religiously. So he was actually showing me that he cannot get a passage through, and he was in very, you know, how when you cannot get a passage through something and you really want to go down that path and you're so frustrated and grumpy. That was his energy. So I kind of turned my back towards the masculine collective because of the channeling which had come prior to that, which was the detachment and the breakup thing. So I did not literally turn my back, you know, or turned in my bed, but I turned my back energetically. Like, I told him kind of with my vibe and my energy that I'm not ready to listen to your thing when you're telling me that you are not getting the passage through. And I did not do that consciously. My energy did that, you know. I kind of turned my back towards him, you know. My energy did that very consciously. The energy was very conscious, but I was subconscious. The energy did it consciously because I also carry the template of all the divine feminine collective, you know. And after making so many mistakes, or after going through a pathway that the divine masculine has been led, it was not his fault, but whatever has happened, you know, the divine feminine collective is kind of turning their back, or not even turning their back to him, you know. They are just focusing on their life. They want to make something of their life, you know, because they are now kind of fed up of living for others, of giving and nurturing and having this loving energy, but nobody is actually acknowledging that loving, caring energy. So, you know, there comes a point when you have to focus on your own life and your own love and give love to yourself, and people interpret that as turning your back for them, you know, because now they can no longer feel your energy. Now they can no longer feel the loving, caring, nurturing which they took for granted for so long or so often, you know. So that was the energy, and that is the energy that I was carrying also, despite my own personal twin journey, you know. I was carrying that template, you know. So I did that, and he started chasing me more, you know. The masculine collective energy that started chasing me more, like, you know, trying to wake me up from that turning my back, or trying to wake me up from actual sleep, my conscious sleep, you know. So in order that I will listen to him, you know. So when I did turn my body towards him, meaning my energy towards him, and I was like, my energy was like, okay, tell me what you want to tell me, you know. So that is when he started. He was showing me something, and I will relay the whole film to you, and I know that you will get it. He was showing me two amoebas, you know, or rounded structures. Now, if you don't know what amoeba is, you can Google it. A-M-O-E-B-A, amoeba. It is an organism. It is a very primitive organism from which all the all life developed, kind of, you know, meaning first the sea life developed, and then, you know, the earth life developed, and then humans developed, you know, and things like that. The amoeba is a very primitive structure. For those who have read biology or some kind of science in your schooling or college, or you might know. For those who don't know, you can Google it and you will find out. You will also see the pictures of amoeba. So amoeba, A-M-O-E-B-A. He was showing me two amoebas, and they look like balls. They look like balls over and over again. Like you draw one circle, then you draw a circle on the outer part of it, then you draw another circle, you know. So like a frisbee or an amoeba, you know. So he was showing me two frisbees or two amoebas, and he was trying to put them together, you know. They were coming, one was coming from the left. Now let's say one amoeba was coming from the left and one amoeba was coming from the right, and they were joining together to form one amoeba. He kept showing me that again and again and again until I started laughing, you know. So what this means is he wants a passage through from point A to point B. He's now ready for union, you know. He is ready for union because you have detached. Remember the last channeling, why I said that this is related to the last channelings, and time is not linear, so all channelings overlap, you know. So, and also I explained to you the spiral, that how the spiral works. It is not linear. It will give you separations and unions again and again till you are permanently ready for that permanent union, you know. So, and you will feel that you're ready for permanent union, but it will be just a temporary one, and then again the spiral will begin, you know. And I'm not saying this to disappoint anybody, but I'm saying this because this is the truth, you know. So what he was showing me, first he was showing me the frustration and the grumpiness of not having a passage through, of the feminine now not giving him the time of the day. This was the energy, let me tell you very honestly, not giving him the time of the day now, you know. And that is why this shift has happened, you know, because now you have very logically and very nicely, like, you have not decided in negative energy that, oh, I'm going to take revenge on him and now I'm going to move away or whatever, you know. You have analyzed all your life, you know. You have looked back at what rubbish you were doing, you know. And by rubbish, I don't mean that, you know, you've just decided that, oh, you know, all this was, yes, you recognize the love, you recognize the divine connection, but you also recognize that what have you been doing in all this time. Always, like, you know, giving, and not just to him, to all of your family, friends and everything, because the energy doesn't just go to one person. If your energy is like that, it will be distributed all around you. And overall, you're analyzing your life, including the twin journey. You're analyzing it that, where was I? Why was I not important for them? Why was I not the person who was receiving, you know? So you are coming into more allowing energies, receiving energies, because now you want to receive, you know. This has nothing to do with per se that you want to just receive your twin. You just want to be at the receiving end of goodness in life, you know. So when this happened and you very logically and very nicely in positive energy decided that, you know, I have to build my life, I have to focus on myself, and this is not selfish, this is not a selfish energy, this is just you coming to the epiphany, you coming to the epiphany of it. And then, you know, because many of you will resonate with this channeling, that you were being told that a breakup is necessary, or a breakup is, you know, is the you know, calling of the day, and you yourself were coming into these energies even without being told, you know, through this channeling, that this is the case, you know. You yourself were coming into these energies slowly or fastly or whatever was the case, and that shift created this in the divine masculine. Can you believe it? I think you can. So this was his thing. He's now frustrated and grumpy that he's not getting the passage through, and he wants the amoebas to collide now, you know. He's ready for union, or he's giving you the message that, you know, why are you moving away, you know, we always work for this and this should happen, and, you know, all that thing he's saying now. And he is now coming up to step up and say, express, you know, through the amoebas that, you know, this, what about this, you know, very sheepishly again, what about this, you know, why am I not getting the right of passage through, why am I not getting these amoebas to collide and have union. But he has to realize that he has to work for it, you know, he also has to work for it. And believe me, it is not a revenge energy through the feminine. The feminine is the most calm, most nurturing, most loving person, and those who are not in this energy, you will first have to reach that energy, divine feminines, in order to process this journey further. And you mark my words, if you're not in these energies of being unconditional, of being loving, caring to yourself first and then to the rest of the world, you cannot progress on the twin journey. I will tell you this also, because anything which is negative in you will be reflected back, and your twin will always be evaded from you. You know, if this is your goal, or if the twin flame journey is your goal, and for other things also, like let's say for jobs and for other things also, you know. So now he's showing that he's not getting the rite of passage. He's getting frustrated, grumpy. He's showing me the amoebas colliding. You know, he's showing me union, that, you know, I want this. And then what happened was, because I got this channeling as a link to the other, that the detachment or the breakup is happening, and that is why this is happening. And many of you are also finding out about false twins and others. So I inquired that, you know, this divine masculine collective, is he a true twin flame, or is this collective energy that is being shown to me, is it a true twin flame energy, and does he really want this now, you know, and does he really, because the detachment has made him through the law of attraction again come to me and show me the union, you know. So I inquired through my, you know, tarot powers, through my tarot guidance powers. So what I got is, I will tell you that. So let's begin with that. So what I got to confirm this message of not getting a passage through and not, you know, and wanting the union. So what I'm getting is, for that confirmation, is that he's really going through a bad time. He's crying and sulking and sobbing. And many of the masculine twins' night sleep has been disturbed, you know, because of you, because of the love that he carries for you. And now he wants to give. And he's actually beating himself up that why he didn't start giving earlier, you know, why he didn't come to these epiphanies earlier, you know. And he also wants to stop the juggling, you know, the juggling between 2-3 people, you know. He wants to stop that. He wants to return to his past life connection, the connection which is from the past, or from the past lifetimes, which is you, you know. And he now realizes that you are the, you know, you are the person who has this emotional depth that he's always wanted. Why has he flipped from one relationship to another, from one bed to another? Because he could not find emotional depth. But on the other hand, he could not even realize that he wanted emotional depth. So he thought that this thing will satisfy him, or that thing will satisfy him. But ultimately now he is realizing that what will satisfy him is depth, spiritual depth, emotional depth, which he can only get with you, because only you carry the template of a spiritual connection. So now he has decided finally that he's going to come to you, you know. Meaning he's also showing me that for those of you who are at a distance, geographical distance, I am also being given the message that he's going to travel to you. Some travel is going to happen, and it is going to happen through him, not the divine feminine. Although if the divine feminine wants to take a ticket and go, I would be more than happy, you know, because I do not promote, you know, anti-feminist activities. So, but here what is being shown is that he is willing to travel now. And this does not just hold true for people who are at a distance. Even if you are in the same city or same locality or whatever, he's going to come to you. But also is being given to me that who are at a geographical distance, country, continent channeling, he is going to travel. He is going to come through an airplane or whatever it means, or ship or whatever, you know. On the other hand, what I'm seeing with the feminine energy is that she is now feeling too much, you know. She's killing her mind with all these thoughts that why did I get into this? Why did I do this? You know, why did I even be with him when I knew that there was so much back and forth and there was so much negativity and narcissism and all that, you know, if some of you have experienced that. And there are a lot of thoughts in your mind, and you are like struggling, beating yourself up. Again, the energy is mirrored. You know, he was also beating himself up, I told in the earlier part of the channeling, and now you are also beating yourself up, and lot of like sword-like energy in your thoughts, you know. But you are going to get some kind of justice. Divorces are going to finish with his side, you know, or some kind of, he's going to put in some kind of legal effort, you know. And again, the 11th month is coming out, you know. September is like, you know, it was September, October, November, but now November is coming out, that November. And what does he really feel? He wants to actually show you that, you know, he has gathered a lot of money and gathered a lot of things for you, and he's ready for the victory march or the processional marriage, you know. So this was my confirmation for what the amoeba thing that he was showing, or the rite of passage. So friends, I hope you found this channeling very valuable, and for all personal readings, please go below to the description box and buy them through PayPal and sending me your story. Thank you so much. God bless. Many kisses. Love you all.